What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to the Black Rose Kitchen. This is your Black Rose boss. My name is Paul Thusi, and I am so excited to welcome to my kitchen, the Black Rose Kitchen, someone very special to me, a brother, a very talented friend, a powerful artist, coming with the most powerful flows, most powerful collaborations, most powerful music. Powerful artist, ladies and gentlemen, none other than the L.E.S, the freshest today!
What's up, my sister? What's up, my sister? What's up, world? What's
I'm
up,
good. World? Welcome to my house. The last time you were, when was the last time you were here?
Actually, this is the first time I've been here.
That's terrible.
I know, but it's fine because I'm here now.
He's known where I live this entire time because he'd be seeing me walking my dogs down the street. Yeah. In fact, I'm going to tell everybody the truth. I phoned this guy literally a few hours ago and I was like, bro, someone might not make it. I need you to make it very quickly. And of course, he made it because I know I can always count on, you know.
All the time. So, you know, hopefully, God, please, hopefully I don't go to jail. But when I do, you better bail me out.
I'll bail you out. You know how big
buttons feel to bail you out. You better be the first person right there bailing me out, but I ain't going to jail.
I better be the first person you call.
Yeah, 1,000%.
But this will never happen.
The plan is
for this to never happen also. Yo, wood, not there. No, wait.
Okay.
Let's just touch something. Oh, this is wood.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So we're going to make a drink today with the L.E.S. That is... I've decided I chose the drink for him because he said he doesn't support a PSL team. So I decided he
doesn't. Don't say that.
He's not into South.
I support the whole PSL movement. I can't pick a team because I'm for South African soccer. How about that? Actually, I support the Eagles, the Nigerian Eagles. Let's start there. Okay. Carry on.
He loves basketball, actually. Yeah. That's why I'm rocking the swag, just so you know, but I'm still rocking my own look.
Oh, nice.
Represent myself. So he chose this moment for me. Shout out to the friend.
Got you.
So I decided he's a North God, most powerful North God. Mm-hmm. And he's the reason I would want to live in Bryanston because he told me it's the place to live. So
Thank
this is why I'm living out here.
Thank you.
and I decided since North is all about this, the right team for him to be talking about today or for us to be celebrating in a drink today is none other than Sundowns.
Okay.
They're not my team. Okay. Do you know anything about, how much do you know about Sundowns?
I know that Patrice Motsepe owns Sundowns, I think.
Yeah,
right? And his son, actually, who's one of the young boys here.
Of course you know Patrice Motsepe's son. I'm trying to think who the hell is that.
Yeah, Patrice Motsepe's son. Kloppy, he's...
I know Kloppy!
Exactly. That's what Tristan said. So Kloppy, he's handling the club, apparently.
Is he handling the club? Yeah, he's serving like a Mutawung moment.
Yeah. Exact, on that exact level, yeah.
Okay.
So shout out to him.
He's serving a Mamkize level.
Yeah, he's doing his thing.
He's doing his thing.
What I'm saying,
Do you think Sundowns does well because they've got a lot of money or because they've got a talented team? Because a lot of people doubt that it's because the team is talented.
Look, I mean, I think it takes a bit of both, you know, it takes a bit of skill and it takes a bit of money. I mean, you obviously want a team that has, you know, high level facilities.
Yeah.
You want the owner of the team to come from the North.
Yeah.
The president to be from the North. I mean, Pena, that's energy that you're sharing. Yeah.
Energy.
But I think, it takes a bit of both, you know.
Which team in the NBA is like the Sundowns of the NBA?
Ooh.
The richest team.
That's a very, very good question. Oh, man, you caught me off guard. No, it has to be LA Lakers.
Really?
Yeah.
Are they the richest team?
I think they are known to be... Their nickname was actually called Showtime.
Yeah.
And when they came up back in the 70s with Magic Johnson and them, they were like the first to bring celebrities. Obviously, it's in Hollywood. Do you know what I mean?
Oh, like so the courtside thing?
They invented courtside. They invented like paparazzi and them being courtside and all of that stuff. So way before New York, but I think New York is Madison Square Garden is just like a little bit more prestigious, but LA Lakers. Definitely.
Why did you choose Cleveland for me then? Because I had a Lakers jersey.
Because LeBron James is my favorite player.
Yeah.
And LeBron James played for Cleveland. And the Cleveland Cavaliers are doing very well.
Okay,
yeah,
so
I'm not a hater.
So I'm into basketball too. Not last question I want to ask you is who is the Michael? I'm not going to ask you in terms of South African soccer because might be tricky. Who is the Michael Jordan or the Kobe Bryant of soccer right now?
Okay, so I'd say the Michael Jordan of soccer is gonna have to go to Messi.
Yeah.
obviously, because now he just won the World Cup.
Even before that, even if he didn't win the World Cup, yes, for me, he was still the best.
But yes, 100%. And then I'm going to have to go for the Kobe Bryant right now. I'm going to have to give it to Mbappe.
Powerful.
1,000%. You know what I mean? A black man, did his thing. And I believe in him in the next 4 years. He's going to get the cup again. And it's French.
I wish African leadership could get like their shit together, because if African leadership got their shit together, we could have these players actually play for the actual teams. But do you know, Mbappe was apparently Mbappe or one of the African players in the French team tried to go home and play for their team. Then whoever was in charge there said,
the dictator.
But in the world of soccer, punished him with like trying to make him pay to play.
Yeah.
I mean, what part of the game is apparently?
That's the greed part of the game.
Anyway, before we talk about you and what you're going to be up to, let's make this drink so that we're sipping on something while we do that.
Yeah.
So what we're going to need right now is 2 glasses.
Okay, but first, what we need is a name.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Fair enough.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
So
I thought the taste was going to inspire the name, but I like this energy.
Yeah. Exactly. So I'm going to go with Rich North.
Rich North, the Rich North drink. We're about to make nothing else but
the Rich North.
The Rich North, because exactly. That's what we represent.
Exactly.
All right, cool. Talk to me. Let's do this. You're doing it. You're gonna have to do it.
Okay, cool.
Because you're gonna, and I already know what you're gonna say. We know what you're gonna say.
Exactly.
I'm gonna get lit. I'm gonna teach you this, and you're gonna teach me that.
Okay, cool.
So. For once, also, someone else is getting him drunk on camera, so that's kind of... All right, cool. So we're going to use the ruby. Do you like my new packaging?
I love your new packaging.
It's powerful,
right?
It's dope. Okay, thank you. So we need 2 shots of this.
Cool. So don't we put ice first, no?
Yes, you need to put ice, actually. My bad. Look at you. Hey, Ghana, you used to punish with the vodka level.
Listen,
so you understand the cocktail level.
Besides the cocktail level, like, you know, I taught you everything you know. I mean, at the all-white pool parties, who's making you those drinks?
Hector.
Who?
Oh, so let's make for both of us. So put 4 shots.
Woo! Let's go, baby. Okay, so this is the double right there.
Yeah.
That's your double right there.
Do you drink gin often? No, I don't.
When I'm in London.
Ooh.
Yeah. The reason why I say that, because gin is very popular in London.
Oh, okay. Yeah. It is.
It's very, very, very popular in London. So while I'm in London, I get to taste
flavored
all the gins.
Gin or like just normal, like
just
normal
the straight. normal gin. But I won't lie, your gin is very, very, very smooth. Every time we partying in Cape Town, and you always put me on.
Now we need half of this.
Okay.
So you're gonna put 1 shot because you're making for 4 shots, a full shot.
I got you. Yeah. So tell me, how has it been for you being in the business of
alcohol?
Yes.
It's quite a wild. Like it's super monopolized.
Yeah.
It's like people's support is really, really necessary.
Oh, congratulations.
Like with any business, I guess.
That's dope.
1 shot of this as well. So it's been tough, but yeah. I'm always up for a good challenge. Giving up is not really something that works well.
It's not in your DNA. It's not in your DNA. I taught you well.
Okay. 2 spoons of this, let me give you
2 spoons of this. What is this?
That is a mango puree.
Oh, nice.
So we actually made it like from, got a mango, cut it up, and then
beautiful. Nice. So, how many spoons?
2.
There we go. You know I'm left-handed. Fun fact.
Really? You know, we had Brian Maloy here not so long ago, and he's ambidextrous.
Okay.
He's serving ambidextrous.
And you know where he lives?
Right? I could not believe it.
Thank you.
I could not believe it.
Thank you.
Okay, cool.
My case.
I don't know, when he said he lives down the street, I said, you made it.
he stopped while I was with my family, actually.
So 2 shots
pushing
of this.
The babies and walking the dogs, yeah?
Yes, like walking what dogs?
I've got 2 little, what are they called? My memory's done, but I've got 2 little dogs.
Hectic. Wait, well, what's this? Passion fruit?
Yes.
Pineapple juice. Okay, so 2 shots of pineapple juice.
Okay. Which is 1 full of this.
Yep. Sometimes I mix this thing up. Sometimes it punishes me.
Yeah.
And we're going to get 2 shots of that in there.
Okay. Right. Get 2 shots of that. Whoa, look at that coconut. Do you remember the last time we had coconuts? In the island of Jamaica.
Oh, that was a dope time.
That really was.
I want to add more. I like them.
Oh, I want to add more.
So this is actually lactose free and we took lactase.
Okay, good. Okay. See what I said?
God, the way we were panicking.
No, but let's add more gin. Just to give it more spices to
Simba. This is how people suffer.
You understand? This is okay, I'll do one shot. I want
kill us. It's fine, it's okay. There we go. So you've got a show later on tonight?
Yeah, I got a show later on tonight. We're celebrating a channel's long-serving success. One of our African music channels.
Yeah.
And it's gonna be very nostalgic. Kulichana, Salvin, Amu, you know, all the guys that...
Amu! Gonna be the original Bad Boys most.
The guys that taught you everything you know. Do you understand?
And I won't lie, Amu taught me a lot of stuff also. Yeah,
let's start.
But I'm teaching you how to make this damn cocktail.
So nice, cool.
So, okay, we're going to put some sugar on the glasses just to make it nice and pretty and decorative. Can you please give
a good shake? Shake the room.
You know how to shake without spilling, right?
Of course.
Okay, so all you need to do is...
Boom, shake, shake, shake the room. Boom, shake, shake.
Yeah, you're coming with the hurt.
Warm it up, Chris. Work the body, work the body. You better touch somebody. I mean, I'm playing, you better ask somebody.
Dog, tell me about fatherhood.
Yo, fatherhood is amazing. I've got 3 kids now.
Yo, you wild. You got money. Because no school fees is not a joke.
It's not a joke. But, you know, I don't look at it like that. You know, I look at it as I've got blessings. So I'm well blessed. 3 kids. Obviously, everyone knows Maddie. And I've got 2 babies.
Yeah.
One boy, one girl. Matea, Makai. And, I'm blessed. You know, my family's growing.
Are you going to have more?
Yeah, I probably will. I'll probably have like one.
Why?
Because kids are blessings, bro. I love kids. So...
Why don't you adopt?
Yeah, because I can produce. Write that down.
I can produce too, but I adopted.
Congratulations on that, Joe. That's also like a different, you know, I mean, your heart is unbelievable. My heart was good. You know, I learned a lot from you when it comes
to the heart arena.
Yes, in the heart arena. But yeah, actually, I never thought of it, so I will consider it.
Think about it. Okay, cool. Actually, you pull.
No problem.
No, I'm taking over now.
Yeah.
Everything we need in there.
Clean, epidex, you understand that?
No, don't. Okay. See, the thing is there for a reason.
Okay.
I'll pull one.
No, you two, you're good. Pour for me, please. Nice. So that's really what's going on right now. Okay. It's just fatherhood, blessings on blessings. A bit of content creation here and there. You know, I don't just get people effed up. You know, I actually get to know people's stories. Because, you know, there's a lot of people in the industry that we work with, and we don't even know how far they've come or what they had to do to get there. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean? So I was like, yo, man, I need a platform where people can tell their story. People that I find very interesting. That's yours.
No, I'm just making sure. What is the hell is that?
It's part of the boom, shake the room. It's in the ice.
Oh, shit.
Yes, exactly.
It's making me panic, babe. I'm a little bit OCD, eh?
Not a little bit. You are very OCD. Guys, okay. I want to tell you guys something, right? Here's a little inside industry fact.
I'll be cleaning a club table.
That's one. 2, another inside industry fact is that when you go to a celebrity's house, you must know they've got pictures of themselves everywhere.
Because people send us pictures of us.
Wait. These celebrities.
Get the hell out of my show!
These celebrities, they love themselves so much, they've got every magazine cover, every big artwork. Look, except an artwork from a fan, I understand. But let me teach you guys something. Mirrors. If you love yourself that much, and you come to Elias's house, you got mirrors. Mirrors.
I don't have mirrors because of the feng shui thing.
Yeah. I have mirrors because I love myself just as much as you love yourself. But, you know, to keep every single... Yo, imagine, why Meg? Hype Meg? I don't know.
No, dog, it just looks pretty. It's just leave me alone.
Okay, look.
Mind your business.
Okay, fine. But anyway, that wasn't for you. That was for the viewers out there. Industry fact.
Need to know... Okay, here.
Industry people.
You can garnish your drink nicely with this coconut moment here. I mean, with this pineapple
moment. What is this?
It's pineapple leaves.
You know what leaves I like. Leaf, baby. Yo, come on, man. Give me the real trees, man.
No, we're not garnishing with those trees.
Yo, we're about to soon.
Ah, hectic. We're about to soon.
That's not hectic, bro.
That's very hectic.
That's not. It's our leaf.
So we're making like a little island. Maybe this can just be our Jamaican moment.
Oh, man, we had such a good time, man. RIP to Reva, man.
Yo, dog.
What a special angel we had. Wow. Anyway, so.
Look, you just made a cocktail, friend.
Cool.
But you do like making cocktails.
I can taste it.
But now you can't see the pineapple, bro. Come on.
OCD. OCD.
There it is, ladies and gentlemen. It's more orange, more ruby than it should be, because obviously our friend here decided we need more of that black rose. But now you can see the power of
the black rose.
The blood orange.
So this is the rich. This is Rich North.
Rich North.
Everybody
baby.
Know I love Rich North.
You know we're coming with the trees.
Rich North. L.E.S. Did he hear Rich North? All up in the classic of Rich North.
What's your Rich favorite North. Song of yours?
My favorite song of mine.
Yes.
Woo! You know the catalog is long, friends. let me dig deep. No, I'll say one of my favorite
songs. Okay, which one do you enjoy performing the most?
Dice.
Yo!
Because every time I perform Dice, out of nowhere, Black Rose pops up on stage. I'm like, God, I didn't even know you were here.
I hear my song. Yeah. I don't care you know what I did once?
Yeah.
I once got on stage, you know, and I love that song by Maphorisa and the crew, like Izolo. I don't know. Not knowing that Daddy Wong was busy performing. I just thought, I was there. I said,
and you were performing.
Next thing I turn around, he's there performing. I was a little bit humiliated, but he entertained me because he knows I love the song.
No, and we know, let me tell you something, when you jump on stage with us, honestly, we know it's coming from a pure place. So we accept it, you know, we love it.
So you it's don't not, get
it's not
irritated.
Like, it's not that like little mama moment.
I know mama did too much.
Yeah, exactly. So it wasn't that. It's like, oh, this is our sister here.
Rich
so,
North.
This is to Rich North.
Yep.
We'll take it in two sips. Okay, first we do it like this. We have a little a taster.
Okay, just to get ready.
Just to open the palate, is what they call it. Opening the palate. And then, once we say sharp, one sip, second sip, brain freeze, out.
I'm so stressed.
Rich North.
Okay, let's go.
Cool. Okay, open palate.
I love creamy things. It's nice, right? We need something.
I need that takeaway now, Chuck. Okay,
I'll make you a takeaway, friend. Cheers. I love you. Thank
love
you for
you
putting up.
Thank you so much for having
let's
me.
Go.
Let's go.
Here we go. I'm suffering.
Oh, this is very nice.
Thank you, babe.
Oh, I think we need this at the All White.
I'm gonna bring it to the All White.
Yeah?
I'm gonna bring Will to the All White. Oh, look, my mixologist is saying I'm ready.
Jeffrey?
I'm not Jeffrey.
Jeffrey? It's okay. Will. Jeffrey! At the All White, his name is Jeffrey because we're wearing All White.
Hectic. Okay, second sip.
Second.
What are we sipping to now? Our children.
Our
wealth,
children.
Health,
amen.
Happiness,
amen.
Joy.
Amen.
Power.
Happy New Year. After that. I could do that my Maphorisa verse. Listen.
Only you could have done that. I have a brain freeze!
Yeah! Yo, I told you, I knew you were going to get a brain freeze.
What a powerful drink, though!
I said, yeah.
Yo, man, thank you for coming through. I really appreciate you.
Thanks so much.
Oh, you're supposed to now tell me, like, I've taught you how to make a cocktail. I know this is going to go south, but I'm going to do it anyway. What can you do me anyway now? What can you teach me?
Well, I don't know if you heard me for the first time, but I taught you everything you know. The way you dress, the way you smell, the way you smile, the way you dance. I just never taught you that Izolo song. But I taught you how to live here in the north. Actually, that looks like my dog. What dogs are those?
A Yorkie.
Yorkie, yeah.
So you told me which dogs to get. Though I got that. Do you know where I got that dog from?
From L.E.S.
No, I did not get it from you.
You got it from L.E.S.
No, I didn't.
I just never taught you to put yourself all over the walls, but I'm playing. You got a wonderful house, wonderful family. I'm honored to be a part of your journey and a part of everything. And anytime
he's rushing to a massage. That's the North Live. He's rushing to a massage. So we're going to have to shut this down real quick. Anything you want to tell people out there who respect you, love you, support you?
Yo, check it out. Posted my podcast is up on my L.E.S. network. On the two.
The one I haven't been invited to yet.
Yes, oh, no, I'm going to get you on there. But come on, girl, you're not going to save the best for last. And love, peace, happiness, joy to everyone. And it's I'm going to keep forever.
Forever.
Let's go.
I love you guys. Shout out to all my Black Rose bosses out there. I appreciate you so much. I appreciate the people who come out here and celebrate me.
Yes, sir.
Please send all my love and regards to your children, to all the people that you love. Mwah, guys, enjoy 2023 and see you soon in these streets.
I'm a yaga. Nkalagat. Nkalagat.
You're so stupid. Yeah. That's the fastest one we've done to date.
Clean. Okay, yeah. Love you guys. And scene. Shove.
Jeffrey.